Morning, everyone. I totally realize we have not been doing very good with our YouTube live videos. This is Monday morning, and I just want to touch base with you guys, let you know what's happening here at the ranch. We have had a lot of expansion over the last couple days. We also had our open house this last week, our first full day of lessons on Saturday for the summer, and I am super excited about that, super fun. A little exhausting, but hey, it's good. So I just wanted to kind of once again, chores this morning, kind of got done already, but I was out here with Jake and around, and I just wanted to touch base on Jake. We had him as our sponsorship Sunday yesterday. Jake is the founder of this rescue, as most of you know. It did show that he was untouchable. However, I want you guys to know that he's not. He did come in untouchable, but he has come a really, really long ways. He hasn't been messed with over the winter time. So this morning we just decided to go ahead and hook him back up. We're probably gonna pull him in to a run. He lost a little bit of weight over this cold spell. Come here, buddy. So what I want to let you guys know on is Jake has got some pretty rough feet. We've got the diagnosis back that he may not be rideable for heavy use. We've got some hip issues we need to address. And Jake is still looking for a sponsor. Jake has been here since the beginning, and we are desperately needing someone to partner with Jake. Come here. To go ahead and get all of his health concerns met. Here, Jake, look. Yeah, good boy. Good boy. Jake is touchable. He's just had a really rough start. He's super scared of people. But we, getting into this season, we would like to be able to get Jake, the health checks and everything that he needs, so that we can start addressing the other issues. I think that Jake will probably always stay here at the rescue, but he definitely needs a sponsor. He needs someone to partner with him. If you guys are not familiar with Jake's story, you can check it out on Facebook or on our website. We've got his story on our website. But Jake came to us over a year ago, untouchable as a 12-year-old in the Kaufman kill pen. Like, I don't know why you're looking at me. Anyway, so Jake came to us a year ago. He was terrified of people. We pretty much ran him into the trailer through a chute. Anyway, he's come a long way. We actually saddled him last fall. And he did really well. So I'm hoping that we can get him sponsored. So if someone is interested at all in partnering with us and partnering with Jake, for this summer, it's $150 a month to completely sponsor him. We can also do a partial sponsor for $75. Just his basic costs, feed, farrier, all those types of things that we need to, supplements that we need to be able to have him on, is going to be about $150. And then any extra medical care that we need to try and get to him would be a little extra. But we are looking for you guys to partner with us. I'm going to jump this around here. As you can see, we're getting our lean-to up. We've got one more section of tin to put right here, and then we're going to start putting our crossboards up right here for our top. We're super excited about this. Jake's like, I don't really know what you're doing here. So I don't tie Jake up, although he does tie, perfectly well. We're going to let him just kind of hang out right there while I talk to you guys. So we've been using railroad ties, which is great. We are getting our gates in, which is super awesome. Here's Angel. Angel wants to say good morning. Huh, sweet girl. It's ladies' baby. She has a sponsor, which we're super stoked about. Huh, pretty girl. So we're getting our gates in, which is good. We've got some more posts. As you can see, we got our first full paddock done in wood this week. Super excited. We've got about another four to go, but we are super happy to have all wood. As you guys know, I've kind of shared before, we are moving everything to wood because it is so much safer for our horses. I'm going to go ahead and introduce Firefly. This is Firefly. Good morning. Firefly, we went and picked up from Idaho. Her and her mom are here at the rescue. Super excited to have them here. We're going to be using them for lessons. Really excited to have these two here. We rescued them. These two are also looking for a sponsor since they just got here this last week. If you're interested at all in sponsoring Miss Firefly here, she's 15. She's a lover of kids, a lover of people, and you can come out and see her anytime you want when you are her sponsor. So I'm going to go ahead. I was doing chores, but we're going to walk. Actually, I was shoveling poop is what I was. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and walk over here to the barn and introduce you to a couple more horses that we're looking for sponsors for, especially for this summer as the season starts. Today we have lessons all day today. Super excited about it. This is my little tiny break here in the morning. Lady over here who is just herding cows. Remember, Lady came in with Angel. Lady is looking for her sponsor. She's also looking for an adoption family as well. Lady has some minor health issues that we can discuss with you. But Lady just started training again since last fall. We've been riding her. She's actually doing really well. She just needs a little bit more miles, but she's been absolutely great. She's a little over 14 hands. She's going to be an amazing kids horse, amazing family horse for somebody. So let us know if you want to sponsor Lady. She's also available for adoption on the website. We have Ezzy over here. Ezzy is also looking for a sponsor. She's one of our lesson horses, one of our favorites. She did have a sponsor last summer. They are not able to do it this summer, so please let us know if you're interested in sponsoring Ezzy. We really use her for the riding program. She is vital to what we do. Okay, over here we have Afton. Afton is Firefly's mom. She came in with Firefly this last week, and she is also looking for a sponsor. We, as you guys know, it's vital for us to be able to have good lesson horses here at the ranch to continue our educational program. Afton is one of those horses that we plan on keeping here at the ranch for the program. However, she does need to eat, and she does have farrier needs. And things like that. And she's 20, so she's getting up there a little bit. So we definitely need a sponsor for Afton. You can come out and see her. Say hi. Bless you. Bless you. If you're interested in sponsoring Afton, please check out the website. We're getting all of them on there. Let's see. We'll go down the line this way first. Excuse my nose. We've got a little bit of a breeze out here, and so it's getting a little crazy. All right. This is our paddock section over here that we're actually looking to put railroad ties in and put some permanent wood, runs down here for our horses that need work. So here we've got Snowflake. Snowflake's one of our lesson horses. You guys have seen her a lot. She is looking for a sponsor for this summer as she's here for lessons. Let's see. We've got Phoenix over here. Phoenix came in not too long ago, and he is not a lesson horse. He is a rescue, 100%. He is about ready to start his training. He's had two sessions so far. Hey, you know, they can't see when your nose is in the camera. He's not a fan of ducks. Okay. So, Mr. Phoenix here is looking for a sponsor while he's here getting training. He's actually perfectly healthy, but he has some attitude some attitude issues that we need to address in training, and then he'll be an awesome horse. He is actually rideable. He just needs a tune-up and some manners, which is why he's here at the rescue. So Mr. Phoenix here is available for adoption once his training is complete, and he has a good fit, but he is looking for a sponsor until then. All right, we've got one more down here on this line. We've got Miss Fancy. Fancy's got a handful of issues. She was in the pasture, but she's in now, lost just a little bit of weight. Fancy has what you call heaves. So it's like asthma for horses. So ultimately, we need to find Fancy a sponsor. We also need to find an adoptive home for Fancy where she can be on 100% grass. Out here, as you guys know, is super windy out here, and we don't have any trees. So the dust really blows out here. Ideally, Fancy needs to find a place, maybe in the hills, maybe with some shelter and a big pasture. We had her at a foster home last summer that was all grass, and she did splendidly. The kids rode her everywhere. She's 100% kid safe. She did really, really well. Her only issue is she needs to be on grass and out of the dust. We have her in right now on wet feed because the dust is so bad out here, and an antihistamine to keep that lung issue down. So if any of you are interested in sponsoring Fancy, or better yet, adopting her, and you have a big pasture or you're out of the wind, please get in touch with us. This is vital for Fancy. She really needs this as soon as we can. I would say that's one of our emergencies. Okay, flip the camera around because I got a little bit of a jaunt over here to the barn, and I'm gonna touch base with you guys on who we have in the barn, because I feel like I don't get to touch base with you guys, and I actually had a cancellation this morning. So I'm gonna try and do some more videos and then upload them as I get the opportunity. Hi to Copper. Hi, Copper. Okay, so we're gonna come over here to the barn and let you know kind of who's in the barn, who we're looking for sponsors for. We're also looking for company sponsors. We definitely need that assistance this year. Hay is going up, gas is going up. Okay, so here's Carl. Carl came in a couple months ago. Carl has been our interesting case. Carl's a thoroughbred. He's only 6, and he is a cribber. So he came in pretty skinny. However, he continued to crib, and we tried several different things to try to get him to not crib, try to reduce stress, things like that, and he's still pretty persistent on the cribbing. Hi, buddy. So we ended up having to go to what we call a cribbing collar right here. When horses crib, they actually pull their head back and they suck air up into their nose, and it goes up into their head. It's kind of like a high from like a drug high. You're silly. So by putting this collar on, it doesn't hurt them. It's tight enough down here to where they can't pull their head back and suck all that air up, because they actually fill their belly with air and then they forget to eat, is what happens. It also damages their teeth. Luckily, Carl's teeth, we caught it soon enough. His teeth are in pretty good shape. But as you can see, body score wise, this is what happens. He thinks he's full, but he's not. Carl also got picked on a little bit in the pasture. So we went ahead and pulled him back in, put this cribbing collar on, which has been great once we got it situated. And now he gets fed 3 times a day. He's actually picked up about 20 pounds in a week. We're super excited. So he's starting to eat. However, he is a thoroughbred. He came off the racetrack. He won about 40,000 on the racetrack, and then got injured. And he had a broken leg on this side, which didn't heal properly. And he had some permanent damage to this right hoof. So Carl will never be able to compete again, but he is 100% friendly and mellow and excited to be part of our program here at the ranch. So Carl is looking for a sponsor. He actually desperately needs a sponsor because his feed intake is higher than some of our other horses here. As we're trying to get his feed built back up and trying to manage his stress, he's actually on a calming supplement. As he's not cribbing anymore, he can get a little antsy sometimes, and so we've got him on a calming supplement, so he does require a little extra care right now. So if you're interested in sponsoring Mr. Carl here, come out and visit him, check out his story, brush him out. He would be super, super thankful for that. All right, then we've got Miss Livy here, who was out in the pasture, but we decided to bring her in, give her some special treatment for a little bit. Miss Livy came down from Texas. You can read her story on our website. She was brown when we brought her home, and as you can see, she is roaning out. We call this a bay roan, brown and white. She's totally roaning out, which is really, really pretty. All that white hair underneath is coming out. Livy is due for some special treatment. We're going to start using her around the kids and getting her acclimated to everything. She was also untouchable when she came in. Now she gets love every single day. We can touch her all over, pick up her feet, brush her tail. She's been doing really well. So Livy actually has a sponsor. So she is doing good at this moment. All right, then in here, we're gonna have two. Buddy is out eating. Buddy is back here. I don't know if you can see him. There's Buddy. Buddy is one of our permanent residents here. He's about 25, 26. Retired roping horse. The family wanted him to be used for kids in his retirement, so here he is. He is looking for a sponsor while he's here because he is also vital to our program. Here we have Victor. Victor came in over the past 2 weeks, and you saw on Facebook his introduction. Victor is 100% blind. He's only been blind for about 2 years. He was a cart pony, as far as I know. So Victor is looking for an adoptive home. He is rideable, but with the blindness, we are really focusing on that connection. Victor is super friendly, super calm to be around. He just can't see. So you gotta talk to him when you come up to him. Hi, buddy. He's thoroughly enjoying his hay right now. Hi, buddy. So he did receive a sponsor this weekend. We're super excited about that. But he is looking for an adoptive home. We would like to see him get an adoptive home that understands his condition. Get away from the music here. All right. I know this has been a long video. This is kind of what happens when I don't get on here very much. We just got a couple things left. I'll let you guys go for your nice day. I've got a couple minis back here looking for homes. We've got Leo right here. He's rideable for kids. Needs probably an experienced kid just because he's a little on the shy side still. We've got Stormy. We use her for our program. She's vital for our program. She's looking for a sponsor. So is Leo. Leo's adoptable though. And then we've got Skid over here. Skid's looking for an adoptive home and a sponsor. And we've got Tate. Tate is our little mini stud here. Tate will probably stay here at the ranch until we get him fixed. We kind of decided that he needs to stay here. We don't need to add to the problem and create more little Tates. So they are all rideable. They're all looking for a sponsor. They're all adoptable. Sponsoring a mini is only $75 a month, as they don't eat as much as a full-size horse. You're also able to come out and visit them anytime. They're gonna be around for our Easter egg hunt. So with that being said, now that I've ran this video about 20 minutes long, sorry about that, but check out the website. We're doing some updates. I'm pretty sure Afton and Firefly have not made it on the website yet, but we are working on that. But they do need sponsors. All of these horses out here need sponsors. We're super excited to be able to partner with you guys this summer and all the families that we can reach with your assistance. All right. Thank you guys. Please let us know if you have any questions. Sign up for lessons, and we will see you again hopefully soon. Thanks.